Thank you for viewing the Storm how-to series. Here is a short video showing you how to check calibration or recalibrate a job. From the main menu, select Jobs. Next, select the job you wish to use. Next, touch Start Treating. And finally, select Continue. In this screen, it gives you an overview of the last calibration. Please select Recalibrate Pumps. An important screen pops up talking about the risk of calibration cylinder overflow. Select Continue. Again, another important screen pops up. This asks you to set the calibration valve to the proper position for the pump being calibrated. Ensure the liquid system is free of air leaks and flow obstructions, and to ensure the pump tubing is properly installed. Select Continue. Here is the main calibration screen. It gives you an overview of the last successful calibration. Why would you want to check the calibration? Maybe there's been a temperature swing, the viscosity of the product has changed, you haven't used the job for a day or two. These are several reasons why you might want to check calibration. To check calibration, we're simply going to touch the Prime button, hold Prime until all of the air is out of the calibration cylinder. Next, touch Empty, and empty to the zero mark of the calibration cylinder, and then select Start Test. During this test, it's going to run the last calculated RPM and the last time of test. If successful, we will collect 1,000 mils. When the test is finished, enter the amount collected. If the viscosity has not changed, the amount collected should be 1,000 mils. In this case, it has changed, and we've collected 960 mils. Select Next. We've got two different options in the calibration test result screen. We can use the resulting treating speed, which means we'll slightly reduce our treating speed, or we can try to reach the target treating speed. In this case, we're going to reach the target treating speed. We then simply empty the cylinder to the zero mark. We now have a new calculated set point, and we touch Start Test. We now enter the amount collected in the cylinder. It's now 1,000 mils. Select Next, and we now have a successful calibration. Before continuing to pump 2, we must empty the cylinder completely and continue to pump 2. Again, an important screen pops up asking us to change the calibration valves to the proper position, making sure the liquid system is free of air leaks and obstructions, and ensuring the pump tubing is properly installed. Select Continue. We now repeat the process for pump 2, priming until all of the air is out of the cal cylinder, emptying back down to the zero mark, and selecting Start Test. In this case, the water has not changed, and we've successfully collected 1,000 mils. Next, select Next, and we have a successful calibration on pump 2. Before continuing, we must empty the cylinder and select Continue. We've now successfully checked and recalibrated our job. Touch Continue. An important screen pops up, ensuring that the auger mixer gearbox lever is in the forward position, the cal valves are now in the treating position, and ensuring that it's safe to proceed. Touch Continue.